Hello, Fog, and welcome back to a new episode. It's me, Sapphira. I'm glad I get these little things because I'm twisting up my braid ends. I'm going to re-dip them in hot water. Just because some of them weren't curled, I asked the lady to like give me beads at the end, and some had curls in them, but the beads she put on was a hot mess. But she's great when it comes to braiding my hair, but the beads were just not working. So I never got the chance, because I had my hair done the day before New Year's. And I was busy because we did something in the house. So I never got the chance to really do the rest of them. And then the ones that are done, they're kind of looking a little rough. So I just wanted to re-dip them so they could get some bounce back to them. But right now I'm getting dressed to go out, I believe, for some drinks. I was originally supposed to go out to dinner today, which is a vlog that I wanted to do with you guys, but my days just got really overwhelming. My best friend, who I was supposed to go out with, her hairstylist was taking a long time to like begin her hair, and I just canceled the reservations. So now we're just gonna go out for drinks and see how that goes. I'm excited though, because I just want to get off the house. Tomorrow I plan on purging my whole closet and all my drawers, because it's just, sometimes you would think I was a hoarder. Like, I just have too many things and too much clothes and hats and stuff I don't wear, which I'm gonna be honest, even something like this, which is the sweater from the college I went to, it has an oil stain right here. I don't know if you can definitely see it in the camera. It has an oil stain, so I don't wear it. Like, I'm really only wearing it right now because obviously I'm in front of this camera. But this sweater was popping when we first got there. Like, everybody was mad hyped to get this one. And I love it, like it reminds me of school, but it's things like this that low-key I need to throw away. I mean, of course this I won't throw away, but like other things that I have that are like, I have an attachment to that just needs to be thrown away, like. So, I hope I'm not breathing too hard and I don't sound like Tony Soprano, because that's not cute. Unless he does it, that's when it was cute. I kind of like chunky men though. Not like crazy, but like, you know, a little husky. I had a really big crush on Tony Soprano. He was in my dreams one time. That's how I knew I was OD crushing on him really hard. But outside of that, I have this beautiful candle I made out in Miami. It smells so good. I made it with vitamin C oil and sandalwood, and it smells really good. Like, I love it so much. And if I ever do go, I don't know if this place, I think it's called Candleland. I'll put the link in the description of the place that we went to, but we went in October to Miami for the weekend for Courtney's birthday. And did candle making, and I just love my candle. It actually inspired me to start making candles, so definitely when I start making them, I'm going to show you guys the candles I make, and I'll probably make an Etsy for it, because I want it to be more of like a hobby for me as opposed to something that I'm doing to like really make money, which of course I'm not just gonna be just making them just to make them, but you know, of course I'm gonna see a profit, because I can't just be. So these are some Gucci tights that I got, like, actually I got them for my birthday in 2020 of March, the year it all took place. And I wore them a few times, but I wore them last year for New Year's actually, when I was out in Vegas. But these are done, like, these are not live anymore. So I seen this girl on TikTok turn her Gucci leggings into a like shirt. So that's what I think I'm gonna do with them. Well, not I think, that's what I know I'm gonna do with them. So I'm about to cut them up and then I'm gonna put them. I'll show you the shirt I'm gonna put on top of it. Sorry, I look back like that because I was hoping my butt wasn't in the camera, but obviously my waist is low. So I was gonna wear this top, this cutout hole on top of it and just have the sleeves out. That was just gonna throw in some jeans. I was like going through it a little moment ago because one, I've been wanting to like record a lot more content than I have been, and I just feel like I've been slacking and not doing things as good as I should be doing them. And then I got overwhelmed about not having a outfit to wear out because I was looking for an outfit earlier on in Williamsburg and it was not successful at all. But I just became really overwhelmed by everything, and like I let that kind of attitude and that mentality take over my mind in like 2020 and somewhat 2021, and I'm just not having it this year. Like, I'm not gonna be a Debbie Downer when I feel as though things aren't going my way, or I'm not doing things as fast as I could be doing them, or as good as I feel like I could be doing them. All I'm gonna do is just keep in mind that unless I keep working towards it or doing it, I won't be better at it, and or I won't become basically successful at it, or it won't become a skill for me, if that all makes sense. Like, I have to push myself more before I'm giving up. Like, oh, you're not doing this, you're not doing that. That doesn't make sense. You have to go and do it. So I'm letting that whole mindset, I'm leaving it in last year because I'm just going forward with things. So that's why I got on TikTok and I was thinking to myself, what, like, I have more than enough clothes to figure out what I'm gonna wear. So I was like, what do I have in my closet that I could wear now, today, and enjoy? And those tights, I could buy a new pair of them. I wore them twice. I have photos in them, so it's kind of all dead. I'm gonna cut this top. Let me see. Oh, my scissors are right here. I have these beautiful fabric scissors. Are only supposed to be used for fabric. I've been using it to cut my candles when I make my candle samples, but which that's technically kind of thread. But I have to cut a small hole at the coochie part, and then I'm gonna cut holes at the end for the my hands. So. And the good thing about tights is, like, you can make a small hole, and then when you put your big ass head through, it should be able to just, like, work. You know what I wish I could have right now? Claw daddies. That would be good. Like some oysters or something. I'm gonna make a small hole because, like the girl said, well, yeah, I'm gonna cut it like short because, like, you know, once again, these are tight, so after I put it on, I could just adjust it. It's not a big deal. But I'm gonna try this top on and then I'm gonna clip back in. Okay, so I'm back. This is what it looks like so far. I have long legs, I guess, like. I don't know, it's just not working, like, really at the end, but it's not too bad. Looks cute. I could actually wear this just like this, but it's not that hot. Like, you know, obvious, not even it's not that hot. It's not, like, summer or spring. It's winter, so I can't really go out like this. But I'm gonna put this top over it, and I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like. Okay, so this is what it looks like. I'm going to, like I said before, I'm going to use my lint roller on the sleeves. I do not remember this top being this tight. Like, I don't know if I'm like, it's like I'm having sex. Like, I'm joking. I might edit that part out. But yeah, it's really tight around my neck, but I don't know. Let me see. I think it looks cool though. It looks very winter. Okay, I should go boil the water for this. I'll be right back.
I'm back with a big ass blue drink too.
I'm actually being a little dramatic. It's actually not that good, but it's good enough right now. I put tahini on the top. This is the second time that I've been making the drink and started stacking the ice in the cup, forgetting that I need to put my salt around the rim. So that's why I just like put the lemon on top, put the glass over my sink and just like shook the tahini on top, because what the fuck, like, think, Sapphire, think. So Karen basically likes the top. She thinks it's cool. She thought I could pull it over a little more. I'm gonna bring it down so I could just see, but like if I pull it over to make it even or like up, you see, that doesn't look good. I think it looks better like stretched out, like lower. So I'm gonna just leave it like this. My only problem is my cross that gets stuck into everything just keeps on nagging it. I have my water boiling and put my hair in, but the benefit of wearing black, you're a messy girl. What was I saying? Yeah, my mother was trying to buy. Oh, obviously, the desk is needed because it's not enough space in my dresser. I have pictures on my dresser, I have a scarf, I have like little knickknack stuff, perfumes, and lip scrubs and all that kind of stuff. Yeah. I know you're about to see much. Because I really be whipping my little ones and twos together. And I'm going to try to do it right here. But, because I can't really see too well. As y'all can see, I don't have on my glasses. But, yeah, I always make jokes like, you know, Sweetie calls herself the baby hair princess, but I really think I might be the baby hair princess too. Like, what? And I'm not saying Sweetie cheating, because she's my girl. I really love Sweetie. But you know, she mixed, so she get a pass. And like, you know, just, I'm not saying it's exactly easier for her, but I know it ain't this motherfucking hard. I think I'm doing pretty decent to like not like really be able to see, because I have my ring light over this. And it's like in front of my mirror, so it's even worse. And then, I just know I'm breathing hard. Like, I just, like, I could low-key hear it. So weird. Well, obviously I'll be, but I feel like I'm really like a real fat man. He takes all my energy. I wonder how bad that's going to sound when I play the video back. But that song was in my head, OD, from TikTok. I think I need to go look in the mirror. Once again. I'll be back. So I can't find my scarf, but I have my Trini scarf, which I wear this sometimes to bed. And I can't find my normal scarf. I had the scarf for so many years. But I got out Labor Day one year.
The haters will say it was forced. It was not forced. I really just backed my shit out. The fuck? Anyway. Yeah, so your girl really don't wear makeup. Well, not really. I don't wear makeup. I used to wear makeup in like high school and college, but as y'all can see, I still be dealing with acne. My dad's side, like, they have acne and stuff. Obviously not everybody, but like, it's a thing in my family. Like, we suffer with acne, and that's part of the reason why I changed my diet and I don't eat meat. And I try to stay away from dairy. Like, the only thing that has me by the fucking neck is butter and cheese here and there. Like, I'm not crazy about cheese because I low-key think I'm one of those lactose intolerant girls. But, yeah, I definitely do love butter. But as far as milk and stuff, like, I don't like milky things. The only time I really have, like, when I mean milk, I mean, you know, whole milk, 2% skim. Like, I don't really do that. When I have coffee, I have almond or oat. I like non-dairy ice cream, but, like, sometimes when me and my roommate are, like, together, we have Haagen-Dazs. But, yeah, I don't eat meat, and that's why I really don't wear makeup unless it's an occasion, like, someone's birthday or my birthday, duh, or, like, New Year's, or, like, it was a special occasion, basically, because I just don't want to clog my pores. I have really oily skin. I think if you've seen early in the video, I have a bump right here. We had to start wearing our masks every day at work. So, like, having the mask on all day is just, like, it's not hot for me. Like, especially the fact that I'm working. So, yeah, that's my story, guys. But I do wear mascara. And I do. My best friend, she just got me these little sample things, which is really cute. And I actually like them, so I'm going to look into. I wish I had the box that she got them for me in. But this one, the darker one, is 19 La Rose Perfecto Liquid Balm, which is perfect because, you know, I can't wear lipstick because even though I have so many MAC lipsticks from back in college and high school, I still have Ruby Woo. That was my shit. That was Rihanna shit, and it became my shit. But, yeah, I still have my lipsticks. I don't know. Y'all gotta let me know if that's good or bad, like, if I should throw them away, because I know a lot of times when you open things like this, you probably can't keep them for too long. But I still have them just in case I ever want to use them. Like, I did put the Ruby Woo on one day, but I was in the house. but I did put it on one day just like bullshitting. But yeah, I still have my lipsticks. But oh yeah, this one, sorry, I'm always like losing my, well, why do I need to do that? Obviously, like, they're both dirty. Oh, this is La Rose Perfecto too. But oh, I guess this is La Rose Perfecto is probably the name of the balms. And this is 001. And I'm all about the pink vibes. So, and I like this pink because it gets a little tingly on my lips. And it makes them even more pink. So, I'll be rocking with it. And, you know, when I say I don't wear makeup then, I just do lipstick and mascara. I'm not talking about, like, makeup is bad or anything. It's just not fitting for me right now, like, to do every day. Sometimes I do miss doing makeup, especially when I'll be going out with my friends and they taking forever because they doing their makeup and stuff and just how cute they look after. And I do be wishing sometimes I could, like, cover up some of my acne scars, but it's just not worth it to me. Like, it's not worth potentially getting even more breakouts or, and I know there's tricks and all this, but I've adjusted to not wearing makeup for so long at this point because I graduated from college in 2017, so that's what, 3-5 years ago almost now. Like, at this point, I don't even really be caring, like, not that much to, like,
put it on. And I just put on mascara, you know? It was to make my eyes pop and my glasses. See, that pimple's pissing me off. But yeah, you know, I just be holding it down for my chicks that's dealing with acne. Even though I'm 25. But I just be trying to hold it down for the girls, because it's a hard knock life. And
I have been offered Accutane. I've just been so scared. Like, I know, what is there to really be scared of? Being that I put a little bit too much blue carousel, like, that shit is blue. But, like I was saying, like,
of course, it's nothing to really be scared of. Because people obviously are fine on it and it's helped them. But
if I'm being truthful, like, the whole, I was on birth control before, but I chose to take my birth control out after the 5 years was up. Because I'm just be trying to be, like, as clear as possible. Like, I want to be Sapphira. Like, I want everything to be natural. As natural as I could get it to be, you know? Like, I just want to be as close to God and as close to the earth as I can be. And I hope I don't sound like a Looney Tune. And even if I do, I know what I mean. But, like, the side effects, the drying out of, you know, lips and not drinking for some, which not drinking will be beneficial for me, but most likely. But, like, just the, what is it? 2 birth controls. But I believe 2 birth controls, I think condoms are part of that. So I believe it would be like, you know, Marina and Implanon pills, shot, whatever, and condoms. So, but I don't know, like, all the side effects, the dry skin, the dry lips. As I told y'all before, I don't know if I said it in my last video, my lips be dry. I know it's not really cute to be saying that. Like, it's not on purpose. Obviously, when I'm around guys that I like, or I'm interested in, or I don't know, or people I don't know, I make sure that my lips are not dry. But, like, my lips dry out a lot. And I'm also always thirsty. Like, always fucking thirsty. So, just, like, things like that. I just, it's not really my vibe right now. You know? I just have this thought that if I make more money, just get more facials, just eat cleaner, it will all work itself out. And I'm going to stick beside that idea. I mean, until I really feel like it's necessary, though. To really do the big move and get it done. I just don't want to be, like, on pills, you know? I've been on, like, different pills for acne, but it was always, like, I forgot what you called them, antibiotics and stuff. And some of them were really disgusting. They were really big. Like, I was just so tired of that shit. And I would say, like, the most change that I've seen in my skin was from no longer eating meat. So, and, like, breakouts like this, like, the small breakouts I have around my face, they're usually because of my period, or they're because I'm indulging in chocolate and desserts pre-period. So that's what I'm saying. It's all about, I was just thinking of discipline. Like, once again, back here. I'm just thinking about discipline. Like, discipline
is like the best thing I could say that I've gained from not eating meat anymore. Like, hold on, I'm about to really flex on y'all. Not too long though. Boom. Boom, baby. We back. We back with the drop curls. It'll be so funny if I got dressed and I did all of this. Tati be like, Sahara. I thought I sound like her. I wonder if she'll think I sound like her. But she'll be like, Sahara. I don't really know if I feel like crying out anymore. Alright, that was more me. That third one I just took out, that shit was trash, okay? So when I woke up this morning, I go into my fucking living room and the fucking window is down. Once again, I do not have one of my glasses. So I'm looking at the window like, I know this window did not fall out of the motherfucker. Like, I know this isn't just a motherfucking bare thing of air and a fucking pigeon can fly in here. And the window sealed, like the whole window was like kind of down. Not the whole, like, you know, it's two halves, like you could put, it's that kind of window, like a city window, like you could push it up. So I'm looking like, I know it's a window. It's not really down. So it was really down. So I'm like, oh my God, like now I gotta deal with this shit. Cause, you know, I'm like the fucking landlady here, man. My mother sees that shit. I'm like, anyway, so I call my aunt and my aunt comes up to help me with it. So we're fucking doing this window. It's like the ghettoest shit ever. Like I live in a private house, but it's, trust me, I'm in the fucking hood. Okay? I'm in the goddamn hood. So we're doing the window and stuff. And then I go and I get ready for like work and stuff. We ain't questioning nothing that God is doing. We just getting through it. But I'm going to charge my camera. Finish putting on my clothes. I'll show you guys what I look like after. And hopefully I go out, it's a good time. And I'm gonna show y'all what's popping off tonight. Cause I had these little trash little curls I redid. Cause y'all, if you don't know, I cannot do hair. Not to save my life. That's why I stay in braids and stuff. But anyway, yeah. So I'll be posted back up with you guys in a moment. Okay, so I'm back because I switched my whole outfit up on y'all, not OD, but I chose to wear my leather pants. Y'all seen them in my last vlog, and those are weeks apart, Thanksgiving, and today, so don't try me, but I'm definitely going to post this vlog, it is what it is. I decided to cut this Cherry Coke shirt that I bought from ASOS years ago that I never wear because, like, my bra is always popping out under, but it works for this, and it looks so cute. And then I just have on my snow boots because obviously it was a snowstorm in New York last night. So I think I'm gonna just switch my jewelry to silver. So I'm gonna switch that, and I'm gonna let y'all know what I look like after. And now this is my Coke top and my necklace, which was low-key not the right way, so I probably need to change that, but yeah, I need to change it, but then just like this, total rock star. We're about to leave out, I'm gonna wear this pink bag, and I want this.
They gonna close.
Tati's being rude as always. Tati, now you have to say hi.
Being rude. Well, like this.
You're fine. You look cute. Thank Don't you. You? Doesn't she look like a Powerpuff Girl? But it's also given very much Harlem Powerpuff Girl. Let's see your feet. Very, very cute.
I know that I hurt you.
Yeah.
I was a child trying to be a man.
To all my sons worldwide, all my juniors,
I let you in
I apologize for my absence. I know I left you without a name to drop. I don't know how I expected you to get your clout up and get your money up, but don't worry. This is not love, baby. Before I leave, no horseshoe. I'm in the bank thinking poor you. I'm in the John Chetry. Supermodels and they all sexy. Lock the door to the bathroom, cause they doing something that is not Pepsi. I'm just pouring shots. I remember that I told you I missed you, that was kinda like a mass text. I remember that I told you I loved you, that was really in the past tense. I remember that I told you truth is that I get around. Mention having us a kid, 42 here, that kid around. Yeah, bit a dick with the top down. Shorties out here getting knocked down. City coming off a lockdown. Rap niggas doing weak features for a pop up, pop down. Used to wanna throw the rock up. Niggas know how I rock now. You know how I rock now. I am forever. Big owl, big birds forever.
I'm going to show you guys this building that they just recently built, because they're building tons and tons of buildings in Harlem. But I'm going to show you guys because it's a beautiful building that will more than likely be filled up with white people. Of course. Let me show you. It's a very beautiful building. It's very beautiful. I'm so scared to see what like Harlem will look like in like basically another like 5-10 years or so. Like, I'm really actually nervous. But hopefully my family's still here, and hopefully I'm still here to be able to get stuff in order. But me and Tati are on a mission to get some oysters. So hopefully it happens.